Determine whether each set of points represents a function. What we need to recall for this exercise is that a function is a relation in which each element in the domain corresponds to exactly one element in the range. The word relation simply means a set of ordered pairs. So let's take a look at A. We have the set of ordered pairs 2, 6, negative 4, 6, 1, negative 3, and 4, negative 3. We need to check and see if each element in the domain corresponds to exactly one element in the range. One way to do that is to make a diagram. Let's first of all write down the elements in the domain. The elements in the domain are the first numbers. So for our first ordered pair, 2 is the first number. So 2 is in the domain. For the second ordered pair, we have negative 4 is the first number, so negative 4 is in the domain. The third ordered pair has 1 as its first coordinate, so 1 is in the domain. And for the last ordered pair, 4 is the first number, so 4 is in the domain. The next thing that we do is we list the elements in the range. The range consists of the second numbers. We have 6, 6, negative 3, negative 3. We only list each number once. So we'll list 6 and negative 3. And then what we do is we draw arrows to represent the relationship. So we have the ordered pair 2, 6. So 2 maps on to 6. We have the ordered pair negative 4, 6. So negative 4 also maps on to 6. We have the point 1, negative 3. So 1 maps on to negative 3. And finally, 4, negative 3, 4 maps on to negative 3. In this case, we see that for each input, there's just one arrow that goes into the range. So that indicates that this is a function relationship, that for each input, there's exactly one output. So this is a function. Now, by contrast, let's look at C. We've got C, the ordered pairs 2, negative 3, 2, 3, negative 2, negative 3, and negative 2, 3. So the elements in the domain are 2 and negative 2. The elements in the range are negative 3 and 3. And then we have negative 3 and 3 again, so just negative 3 and 3. And for the first ordered pair, 2, negative 3, draw an arrow from 2 to negative 3. For the second ordered pair, we have 2, 3, so we draw an arrow from 2 to 3. The third ordered pair is negative 2, negative 3. So we draw an arrow from negative 2 to negative 3. And then finally, the fourth ordered pair is negative 2, 3. So we draw an arrow from negative 2 to 3. In this case, we see that for 2, there are two arrows. That means that there's not a unique output for 2. The output for 2 can be either negative 3 or 3. For negative 2, we also see that there are two arrows coming from negative 2. So it doesn't have a unique output. The output can be negative 3 or 3. This is not a function. All right, so we see in A and C that we can use a diagram to help us decide whether a set of ordered pairs is a function. An alternative way would be to sketch a graph of this set of ordered pairs. So let's take a look at B. We have 2, negative 2, 3, negative 2, 4, negative 2, and 6, negative 2. Let's go ahead and plot those points. We have in part B 2, negative 2, so we go 2 to the right and 2 down, plot a point. We have 3, negative 2, go 3 to the right, 2 down. And then 4, negative 2, so 4 to the right, 2 down. And finally 6, negative 2, so start at the origin, go 6 units to the right, and 2 down. And now we can apply the vertical line test. We see that if we draw a vertical line at any of these points, that vertical line only goes through one point. And so this tells us that this is a function relation. Let's take a look at D. We have negative 1, 2. Negative 1, 0. Negative 1, negative 1. And negative 1, negative 2. And for this one, we see that we can draw a vertical line. If we draw a vertical line through one of the points, it ends up going through more than one point. So this graph does not pass the vertical line test, and therefore this is not a function. So we can see that you can either use a diagram or a graph to determine whether a relation is a function or not.